On Monday, May 10th, we want to look at how photonics could play a much bigger role in reducing fatal cases of prostate cancer. Worldwide, there were 1.3 million cases last year. We also know that many earlier claims that food supplements can help are not true. The real facts are much simpler. The older and taller you are, the greater the risk. So where does photonics come in? In the past year, we discussed the topic of medical lasers and sensors with brilliant surgeons like Dr. Stefano Regucci. They told us exactly what they need.
The problem is that you want to get something homogeneous all over the tumor. We have no measure of which temperature you have inside the tumor.
This time, we will visit the Zucchi Monza Institute in Italy and meet Dr. Serena Marussia. She is a renowned surgeon with profound expertise on laser-based prostate procedures. With her and the whole supply chain in the room, from laser optics and fibers to the laser systems of OmniGuide's Lisa Laser, we want to explore the accelerated adoption of thulium and holmium lasers in benign prostate obstruction. About 40% of men over the age of 60 have a difficulty in passing urine. That could indicate having an enlarged prostate, or in technical terms, a benign prostatic hyperplasia. If left untreated, that can lead to serious infections and bladder stones. But I love it when photonics is the solution. Holmium laser enucleation of the prostate is a very safe process in which surgeons use a laser to remove the extra tissue that is blocking the flow of urine. This process can remove a large amount of tissue without any incisions on the body, while decreasing the risk of bleeding and even providing tissue for pathologists to detect possible cancer. And on this topic, just recently during our live visit to Art Photonics in Berlin, we learned that accurate temperature measurement is essential to spot the difference between cancerous and healthy tissue. Slava explained the huge emerging market of mid-infrared fiber for endoscopy.
They are all based on infrared arrays, but we are able to make a fiber optic bundle or even single fiber endoscope when the infrared image will be transferred through the flexible fiber, and then you can go around the corner and measure, let's say, something inside human body, infrared endoscopy. I mentioned one figure, Jose already was surprised, 40 billion endoscopy. Billion. It's not millions, it's billions, you know? It's bigger than all laser market on the planet.
I can't wait for this one. If you want to propose your company's solution for the urologist problems, then sign up now. As a photonics community, we have the solutions. So let's work together to make the change.